Those of you who have been to sea and have experienced low-flying aircraft attacks will know how infuriating such attacks can be.
Aircraft, red 7-0, angle of sight 1-0, sir.
In spite of keeping a good lookout and spotting the aircraft first, in spite of recognizing it as an enemy machine and being ready to fire the moment it came within range.
Eiffel!
In spite of engaging it fiercely with your whole mind bent on the job. In spite of all that you did, the blighter got away with it. Not enough aim off or wrong wind allowance, perhaps. If only, you say, I could have told where my shots were missing, I'd have brought him down easily. That is what tracer are for. Only it's not quite so easy as all that. Here is a demonstration tracer projectile. Burning composition in its base is ignited when the gun fires and burns long enough to show the path of the projectile at fighting ranges. Here the pom-pom firing tracer. You can see the path of the projectiles as they leave the gun, and this enables you to see whether you are hitting or missing the target. Here are other guns firing tracer. Don't jump to the conclusion that tracer provides the complete answer to all close-range anti-aircraft problems. The tracer is there to help you, but there are several which must be thoroughly understood before you can get any real benefit from it. The first thing is to learn how to observe tracer. If you look at this pom-pom firing, you will see the projectiles appear to go up first in the direction in which the gun is pointing, then they start to drop. This is because of gravity, which, as you know, gives the projectile a curved trajectory. This diagram shows a side view. If your eye is here, and you look along the trajectory, this is where the tracer will appear to be going. And if the target is here, you will think you're missing high, although you're actually missing low. Therefore, don't look along the tracer path. Keep your eyes glued to the target to see where your shots are really going. Look at this approaching target, the Heinkel 111. We are going to stop it and fire tracer so you will have plenty of time to watch what happens. The gun is aimed off ahead of the target, and if you watch the tracer pass, you will see that it appears to rise above the target. But if you watch the target, you will see the tracer dropping short of it. By concentrating on the target, you see only that small part of the tracer pass which shows you the error in aim. You must train yourself to ignore the early part by focusing your eyes on the target. So much for an approaching target. Now consider one crossing in this direction. You know that when engaging a target like this, you have to aim off ahead in order to hit the target at its future position. As before, your eye is here, and if, when the target is here, you watch the tracer leaving the gun in this direction, you will obviously think your shots are going to miss ahead. Once again, then, you must watch the target and wait for the tracer to come up to it. When you do this, however, a curious thing happens. To follow with your eye a crossing target like this, your line of sight must swing continuously to keep on the target. The projectiles are going straight out away from you. But because your eye is swinging across to the left, the tracer will appear to curve to the right. These tracers are hitting. See, it's simply because the human eye can only focus on one thing at a time. Look, for instance, at those clouds. Fix your eyes on that prominent white cloud in the center. There, an aircraft crossed your field of vision, but all you were conscious of was an aircraft crossing from right to left. This is because you were watching the clouds. Next time we will concentrate on the aircraft. Now the clouds appear to sweep away to the right. They are not moving at all, really, but they appear because they are left behind by your eye, which is kept swinging on the aircraft. Here's a target going the other way, and the clouds appear to sweep to the left. Now look once more at tracer. If you're behind the gun and watch the tracer, you can see it go straight out away from you. If, however, you watch a crossing target like this and fire tracer, your eye is swinging across the line of fire, and the tracer will appear to curve to the left. If the target is crossing to the left, the tracer will appear to curve to the right. The amount of apparent curvature depends on how fast the target is crossing, that is, the rate at which you have to swing your eye across the line of fire. This aircraft's aim or speed is now 50 knots, but if it were increased to 100 knots, you would have to swing your eye faster across the line of fire, and the curvature would appear more pronounced. This is 100 knots. Tracer still hitting. This is 200 knots. The tracer appears to flick in from the left. But don't be fascinated by the tracer stream. This is where you should be watching. Keep your eyes glued to the target and wait for the tracer to come up to it. You will then be able, with practice, to tell where your shots are going. The first point is that unless your shots are in line with the target, you cannot possibly be hitting. As a simple example of what I mean, look at this bottle of Guinness. I'm going to take it well out of your reach, and we'll take pot shots at it with a pea shooter. First of all, from this direction. What about this fellow's aim? He's missing left, isn't he? But what about range? Do you think his shots are dropping this side of the target or beyond it? You cannot possibly tell. All you can say is that he cannot be hitting and must come right. Now he's gone too far. He still can't tell whether he's got the right elevation. Why? Because his shots are not in line with the target. Very well then, bring them in line. Now you can tell. You can see his shot dropping between you and the target, missing low in fact. He must come up a bit. What can you see now? His shots are dropping beyond the target. They are obscured by the target as they pass beyond it. Therefore, he's missing high. Do you see now? But until you get your shots in line with the target, all you can say is, I know I can't be hitting. Once they are in line, provided you watch the target, you can correct as necessary to hit. What you've just seen is the same as firing tracer at an approaching target, only of course it all happens much more quickly. Here's a Heinkel 111. I'm going to keep it at the same approach angle for a bit so that we can study what actually happens during one moment of the engagement. The single pom-pom firing now. Remember, watch the target. The tracer are missing right, aren't they? Now they're missing left. Now they're in line. Watch closely. They are hidden for a moment behind the target, aren't they? Missing high. There they are. That's where you should be watching. Train yourself to ignore the rest. Now they're missing low. You can see them dropping down on the near side of the target. We'll help you once more, but remember, this won't be done for you in action. You must watch the target. Now they're hitting. It isn't easy to see hits, except sometimes with explosive shell. But you can see when you're not hitting. Missing high. Missing low. Hitting again. And of course, when you're not in line, it is obvious that you cannot be hitting. So far, we have only considered the tracer fired at one moment during the attack. But you will remember from your eye shooting training that the gun must be swung rapidly to keep pace with the target and that the aim off required increases all the time. Watch during this attack. We'll open fire with a pom-pom just before he comes within range. Don't be distracted by the tracer stream continually pouring out ahead of the target. Watch the target all the time. He's missing left now, not in line. Now he's in line high. Hitting now. Come on, not increasing aim or fast enough. Low. Now he's hitting. We repeat that attack. Try to make your own deductions. Left. High. Hitting. Low. Hitting. Now a dive bombing attack. We'll have to watch closely. Right. Low. High. Hitting. That was a bit swift, wasn't it? Watch once more. Right. Low. High. Hitting. So much for an approaching target. Now for a crossing target. You will remember that the tracer appeared to come in from the side. Look at that for a moment. Now we'll consider it in more detail. Here's another bottle of Guinness, slung on its side. This time, the pellets will appear to come in from this direction. And once again, you'll see that they must be in line before you can tell where they are going. What about these shots? All you can say is that they are high. Are they this side or the far side of the target? You can't tell because they are never in line with it. Anyhow, we've obviously got to come down. What about these? They are just as bad. You still don't know anything except that they can't be hitting and that you must go up. Now you can tell. The shots are in line with the target, and you can see them crossing on the near side of it. They are still in line here, only this time they are passing beyond the target. You can see them disappear behind it and emerge the other side. So once again, when your shots are not in line with the target, you know you cannot be hitting. When they are in line, you can make the necessary correction to give you a hit. Thanks. Just what I wanted. What you have just seen is similar to a crossing target, except that you must study the peculiar effect of tracer. Here is a pom-pom firing. Watch the target now. Where are the shots going? Missing low, aren't they? Are we taking enough aim off? You can't tell because the shots are not in line. And it's the same thing here, only we're missing high. Anyhow, we know we can't be hitting. Come down a bit. Now we're in line. Look at the tracer flashing past the target. There you are. We're missing astern, aren't we? Keep your eyes on that. You can see the tracer flashing by on the near side of the target. You must watch for that, because it will tell you when you are missing astern and that you must apply more aim off. Like this. Now what can you see? The tracer are momentarily obscured by the target and then fall away to the right, missing ahead. Here they are, at the target. Remember what that looks like. Watch for it and ignore the rest of the tracer path. The great thing is, we've got our shots in line and know where we are. Knowing this, we can correct as necessary to hit. Now we're hitting. You can see the tracer going slap into the target. You may not always be able to see that, but you can see when you're not hitting. Missing ahead. Missing astern. Hitting. Ahead. Astern again. Hitting once more. This target is crossing at 100 knots. Now it's 200. Missing astern. Note the more pronounced curve. Ahead. Hitting. Not in line. High. Low. Now we're in line again. Think for yourselves. Turn. Ahead. Hitting. Now let's take a proper attack with the aim or speed changing all the time. Here's a Heinkel coming in to attack a consort. We'll open fire at about 1,200 yards with the pom-pom. Watch the target now. Not in line, missing high. Now low. In line now, but ahead. Now stern. Hitting. We repeat that attack. Note that at first the tracer cuts obliquely across the target because it's neither directly approaching nor directly crossing. Keep your eyes on the target. High. Low. Ahead. Stern. Hitting. Stern. Watch once more. Try to make your own deductions and concentrate on the target. High, low, head, turn, hitting, turn. You've just seen a slow target. Here's the Messerschmitt 110, 300 knots. Watch closely. Head, turn, hitting, turn. Watch that same attack again. Head. Turn. Hitting. Turn. Here's one more attack. This time we'll fire a Lewis. It's a bit more difficult to tell where they're going, so we'll stop the target a moment. You must watch the target and not be fascinated by the tracer stream. Watch closely now. Hitting high. Hitting. Hitting low. Hitting ahead. Hitting astern, watch that, most important. Hitting, now we let the target run on. Hitting low, ahead, astern. You'll see that was a bit different, but the same principles apply. Watch it once more. Keep your eyes glued to the target all the time. High, hitting, low, ahead, astern.